Be suspicious. In any turn, real braking turns accepted, where you're tempted to chop the throttle and or use the brakes lightly, look at it with a suspicious eye and see if good throttle control won't gain an even better result. Amping up your SRs by charging may be exciting, but not fast, and charging doesn't agree with machine design. Throttle control rule number two, in any fast entry turn, calculate the roll-off as carefully as you would a roll-on. Does this also agree with suspension design, weight transfer, and traction? Force gauges. We use the various forces created by our machines in many ways. In fact, we gauge most of what we do by them. Forces produced by braking, accelerating, cornering, etc. are the real stuff of riding. We come to depend on some of them for information or feedback. However, as in the above examples of charging turns, they can be deceptive. Chandler noted, "The majority of your senses going in are focused on speed. Once in the turn, you want to sense the bike's feedback." Sorting out the forces. Perhaps it is difficult to sort out the difference between the higher, around 1G maximum, load of the braking and cornering forces from the much less pronounced acceleration, 0.1 to 0.2G, required for optimum traction suspension. Many riders have trouble with this point. Throttle control produces the least of the forces encountered while cornering, when done correctly. As your turn entry speeds come up and you get on the throttle earlier, you'll begin to discover just how light a touch mid-turn throttle requires. Emotionally, shifting your senses from heavy braking and cornering to light acceleration loads may have some bearing on why it is difficult. After all, abandoning a greater force for a lesser one when you're trying to go fast even sounds wrong. However, we're talking about machine requirements, not a rider's dreams of factory rides. The forces at work. Any turn is full of important forces to monitor. There's deceleration from brake, engine, and wind drag coming up to the turn, the force created by turning the bike, the load from the tires setting, then cornering, tire friction versus centrifugal force, then acceleration plus cornering and wind drag in fast turns, through the middle and exit. Just as in the pain experiment, individually, none of them may be a problem, but two or more together can cause confusion. Forces are something you deal with while riding. The standard techniques of throttle control put you in command over many of the forces, and one of the byproducts is defeating the SRs that accompany those forces. Incorrectly using the throttle to set entry speed, you're making it a little easier on yourself and on the bike. Speed is the force that lights up your SRs quicker than anything. Throttle control is the way to tame them. Donnie Green. At one track, it took Keith 10 years to talk me into using the throttle correctly in the fast turn entries. Gently rolling off and back on at a similar rate can eliminate time-consuming complications such as shutting off the gas, grabbing the brake, and just getting it cracked back on just right. Of course, all the riding time I have has helped sort out the different loads a rider feels on the bike, but now I feel as though I can sort them equally and not have any one of them consume too much attention. Another simple but useful tool is knowing these different ways that the bike slows, the forces at work. Each of them can be used individually or sometimes all together.